But that's something that they want you to commit to today, that you can spend eternity with them. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we do acknowledge that this is the day that you have made, Lord. And Lord, we thank you for that, because you know that we are all sinners and fall short of your glory, God. But because of your grace, we are justified freely in you, Lord. And Lord, it's today that we ask that you bless this food that we are about to eat in your Son, Jesus' name.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Roberts with our blessing. Let's give him another round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you all to grab your glasses as we're going to have our toast to the bride and groom. We're fortunate enough this afternoon to have two, what I'm sure will be fantastic toasts, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to turn things over to the best man in the maid of honor. Please welcome once again Kevin Roberts and Melissa White.
My mom, I'm emotional, so I don't want to start crying. Basically, I want to tell you guys that I couldn't be happier for you. Sarah, growing up, Emily and I always looked up to you, and time has gone by so fast. It seems like the memories of us taking hours and hours to set up all of our Barbies and even trimming their hair and going roller skating or watching Emily at the pool climb up the high dive and look down and then turn back around while she would hold up the line are all fresh in my mind. Or about fighting over the front seat hundreds of times, or my Aunt Susan and Uncle Bill and their family would come and visit in our soccer games that would turn into war. Then you, Christopher and William, versus Julianne, Emily and me. We would go on forever, but the important thing to remember is that we still and will always have all of those memories to cherish, and now I'm so happy to see you start the next chapter of your life, your family. I know that the future only holds good things for you, which can mostly be influenced from the great guy you found and his great family that comes along with him. It's been 6.5 years for you two to grow together, and now it's the official joining of our families that we knew all along was meant to be. Just being over the Roberts house, I feel the warmth and welcoming atmosphere that they all generate. I felt right at home myself when we were all over helping with cookies with Miss Kathy and Miss Dale, or when we came to watch UFC with Scott, Kevin, and Mr. Gary. It's so comforting for me as your sister to know that they all love you so much. By the way, like when you were sick and they came to visit you and comfort you as if you were already their own daughter. Or when we planned your bridal shower, seeing how everyone helped from both families really is so amazing because they wanted the best for you, just as our family always has. Kelly and I wrote many emails coordinating bachelorette evening for you, which really showed me how lucky you, Emily, and I are all to add another sister who's so caring and loving to our life. Now, Scott, I'm so excited that the time has finally come that you are my brother-in-law. I knew it was bound to happen sooner or later, and now looking back, it really came fast, especially when I found out I had to write a speech. really, it flew by. But anyways, you made my sister so happy to be with you, and my whole family happy that we know she met her soulmate. Over the years, you have taught Sarah so much that I can really tell the difference from her before Scott days. You helped with her confidence, definitely with her patience, and gave her a better attitude towards certain things. What else can she ask for in a husband? Not that you already don't know this, but we all love you and welcome you into our family. I know you two will live a happy and prosperous life because that's exactly what you two deserve.
Mine's going to be last year. Scott and Sarah started dating when I was about 14 years old, and one time that really sticks out of my mind is when I was sick for about 3 days, and Sarah came over one day, and as soon as she found out I was sick, she immediately came right up to me, and nursing skills kicked in. She started asking me what my symptoms were, and recommended what medicine to take. She really took care of me that night, and constantly asked me if I needed anything. But it just goes to show you what a big heart and caring personality she has. And even though you're married to my brother today, it doesn't mean that I haven't considered you a sister for a while. You and Scott have been great role models for me. I couldn't have asked for two better people to learn about relationships from. I'm lucky to have both of you in my life, and I believe that everyone here tonight is just as lucky. So thank you and congratulations.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, another big round of applause for Brian. I've done a lot of weddings around here, and when I look into a bride and groom's eyes, you can just feel it sometimes. I know you guys all know that, but, you know, it's a pleasure to be here with you guys today. I'm Scott Wagner from Michael Tate Avenue. Our stand-up, Josh, we have a bunch of guys in here. Josh, Kevin, and Chris, Rhonda is our lead waitress. Anything you guys need, please let us know. That's why we're here. It's a pleasure for us to be here. We're going to start dinner service now. We're going to serve the head table, serve tables one and two, and then we're going to invite table by table up to the buffet. Bar is open. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great time.
Hey.
of maintaining my composure, but I'm a mother, and making emotional puddles is part of the course. Ask any parent in this room, and one thing, too, will be a parental puddle maker. Let me just say, there are tears of joy. All right, here we go. From the first little flutter I felt when pregnant with you, to your first little breath of fresh air welcoming me into this world, I knew that I was one of the luckiest people around. My life had been blessed forever. Your sweet, pink, chubby cheeks. Oh dear, not those. And sparkling brown eyes brought a joy to my heart that I had never felt before. There's no greater joy than becoming a parent. For the first time, Sarah. Second time, Emily. Third time, Melissa. All three of you are my pride and joy, and I thank you a lot for that. Sarah, having the opportunity to watch you grow and to grow together has truly been an awesome gift from God. Sharing your first time rolling over in the crib and seeing your eyes light up. Your first steps with intense concentration and determination. Your first tingles on the potty and celebrating with potty dances. First boo-boos and making sure the boo-boo bunny or me carrying you in my arms, running around the living room, making pretend ambulance siren sounds, and then plopping down on the couch for a good tickle attack to make sure smile came back to your face. Your first day of school in your red jumper and ponytails, you were so cute. Losing your first tooth at the mall, you were so proud. Running to ride your bike in the soft grassy fields at Southside, I didn't want any real silence. Roller skating and learning the coolest dance moves from your friends. Wilson World and karaoke with your sisters, because you three were going to become famous one day. Writing wonderful short stories and later the beautiful poem to my mama. Soccer games and learning to drive. Now that was definitely growing together. Or you may say just the opposite, as I was pushing my brake pedal, pretend brake pedal, and grabbing the car door for comfort. High school graduation and college graduation. We've done a lot growing together, and I'm thankful we have been able to share so much. I'm very proud of the beautiful, dependent, organized, kind-hearted young lady you have become. Sarah, you are an awesome daughter, an awesome sister. And I say that for Emily and Melissa, because I know what I have observed when you are around and they look up to you. You're an awesome role model, an awesome friend, an awesome nurse, and you will be an awesome wife and parent. I wish for all daughters and that gift I received. Wanting my daughters to find their Prince Charming someday.